Good morning. We welcome all visitors to our parish of St. Benedict. The Mass this morning is for Alvin Winter. Please silence your cell phones. As we prepare to celebrate the mystery of the Eucharist, let us take a moment in quiet to remind ourselves that we are in the holy presence of God. Saint Benedict, our patron, pray for us. Blessed Stanley Rother, martyr of the church, pray for us. Please stand after the antiphon.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
My name is Father Jerry B. I'm a retired diocesan priest from Wichita, Kansas, your friendly neighbor to the north. I have some connection here with this parish. My niece and her husband, Julianne and Daniel Bryan, have been in members of this parish for some time, and their family, and Father John Sean O'Brien was ordained 3 years. He's my great nephew. Today is Father's Day, so we offer the Mass in a special way for the fathers here, present, and others, and especially so many of ours are deceased. We prepare ourselves to celebrate the Holy Eucharist by calling to mind our sins.
Lord Jesus, you hear the cry of the poor. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christ Jesus, you turn to those who seek mercy.
Mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Jeremiah said, I hear the whispering of many, terror on every side. Denounce, let us denounce him. All those who are my friends are on the watch for any misstep of mine. Perhaps he will be trapped, then we can prevail and take our vengeance on him. But the Lord is with me like a mighty champion. My persecutors will stumble, they will not triumph. In their failure, they will be put to utter shame, to lasting, unforgivable confusion. O Lord of hosts, you who test the just, who probe mind and heart, let me witness the vengeance you take on them. For to you I have entrusted my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord, for he has rescued the life of the poor from the power of the wicked. The word of the Lord. Sisters, through one man sin entered the world, and through sin, death. And thus death came to all men, inasmuch as all sin. For up to the time of the law, sin was in the world, although sin is not accounted when there is no law. But death reigned from Adam to Moses, even over those who did not sin. after the pattern of the trespass of Adam, who is a type of the one who was to come. But the gift is not like the transgression, for if the transgression of the one, the many died, how much more did the grace of God and the gracious gift of the one man, Jesus Christ, overflow for the many? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
According to Matthew, glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the 12, "Fear no one. Nothing is concealed that will not be revealed, nor secret that will not be known. What I say to you in the darkness, speak in light. What you hear whispered, proclaim on the housetops. And do not be afraid of those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather, be afraid of the one who can destroy both soul and body in Gehenna. Are not two sparrows sold for a small coin? Yet not one of them falls to the ground without your Father's knowledge. Even all the hairs of your head are counted. So do not be afraid. You are worth more than sparrows. Everyone who acknowledges me before others, I will acknowledge before my heavenly Father. But whoever denies me before others, I will deny before my heavenly Father." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus
Brothers and sisters in the Lord Jesus Christ. And we also invite those who are watching this on their television or computer as we live stream here. You're included in our celebration today in a very special way. You are worth more than two sparrows. Every hair of your head is numbered. What a marvelous image of God, who loves each person so personally and so individually. We can hardly imagine that much love and that kind of love for each one of us. And that means the love for our family, for those around us, and especially, as I'm going to emphasize today, on the poor, those that are neglected, those that are most vulnerable in the world. I know a lot of you are suffering, and a lot of our people are suffering from the virus, loss of jobs, or decrease in wages and closed businesses. But that's happening all over the world. And those that are the poorest, developing countries of the world, they also suffer this, and they're probably hit much harder because they just barely get enough to make a living, and then this comes along. I come in the name of Unbound. Unbound is a Catholic sponsorship organization founded about 36 years ago by Catholic lay people near Kansas City. And they founded this because several of them worked in the missions, and they realized how difficult it was even to get an education. And so they began searching out sponsors here to sponsor poor families there. And that's what I'm here today, to invite you, to encourage you to sponsor a poor child or elderly in one of our needy countries. I know a good number of you are already sponsors, because this is the third time we've been to your parish, St. Benedict's, first time I've been here for preach this. And we've had a good response from this parish, and we hope we will have again, and we did last night. So what does a sponsor do? A sponsor does three things. One is prayer, one is to be a friend, a third is to share a little money each month. Every sponsored person prays for us, and we pray for them. So we become prayer companions, supporting one another and praying for one another that we live like Jesus, and that we have as much possible as a love that loves even poor sparrows and the hairs of our head. And ultimately, we're supporting one another, helping one another get to heaven. So we're an eternal blessing for each other. The second thing, we become friends of those we sponsor. We do that by letters and by photos. Every sponsored person writes at least two letters every year, some more often. And every year they send a new photo of themselves. We just see them grow year after year, as we do our own children and grandchildren. We're not obligated to write back, we the sponsors, but we're strongly encouraged to do so. I visited some of these countries and some of the sponsor people. It means so much to get a letter from the United States of America, from a person thousands of miles away that I've never met, and that person is praying for me and is sharing money every month for my support, and took time to write a letter to me, send a photo of their family. So it does mean very, very much for them in the other country. That's part of that friendship, part of loving them. The third duty of a sponsor is to send at least $40 every month to the headquarters in Kansas City. Now, a marvelous thing about that is that Charity Navigator and Charity Watch, if you've heard of those, they're watchdog organizations of all the charities in the U.S. They study everyone and they give us all a grade. And they give Unbound the highest grade, A+ and 4 stars. So that gives us a lot of confidence that our money is well spent and it's used efficiently, and we do what we say we do. Kansas City sends, they only use about $4 of that 40 for all the administration, which is very efficient. The rest of the money they send to the country of your sponsored child or elderly. We work in about 18 countries, most of Central and South America, India, the Philippines, and now 5 countries of Africa. Each of these countries have coordinators of the projects who receive the money and their communication with the family and find out what they need and purchase it and take care of all the letter writing and so on, with many volunteers, of course. So how's the money spent? First of all, and number one, is education. Education is the most important door out of poverty. So it's used for uniforms, as most of the public schools demand, for all the materials they need for the supplies and shoes and clothes and many often food. So these are all the things that it could be used for. And we're now giving the families much more freedom and choice in that. That gives them more dignity. We find out they really spend the money quite well. So after Mass, you'll have a chance to come to the tables out there and select your child or elderly. Unfortunately, Unbound didn't send me that many folders. Only 17 for a parish this size and this generous. So last night we have 70 sponsors. We have some left today. But here's this is the official folder. It's not what it looked like today because of the virus. We had to modify it. But it has a picture of the child on the front. It has the name, the age, the country, and even the birthday. So that's what you'll find at the tables to make your selection. I sponsor two young people, Kimberly from El Salvador. She's 16 years of age, and she sings in a choir in El Salvador. Her parents are very much involved in their church, and she wants to be a teacher. So that's her dream. That's a dream that God placed in her heart. So it's a real joy and honor and privilege to help her to achieve God's will in her life. My second one is Sadamu. Sadamu is from Uganda in Africa. He's 22 years of age. That's older than most of the young people. But he's studying in the university. He's one of eight children. He got a late start, but he's studying accounting in the university there. He, like many of the older children, teenagers and beyond, write much more interesting letters. And he writes long letters. He's like, well, I worked in Venezuela, and people get very flowery in their talking, and they repeat and say things in about five different ways. That's what he does. One thing he said in a letter recently, my family and I have a very difficult life, but you have resurrected all my hope. You have resurrected all my hope. Wow, only Jesus Christ can resurrect our hope. So it's obviously exaggeration, but how strongly he says hope, esperanza. Hope is the most important gift we give as sponsors. Without hope, nothing is possible. With hope, almost anything is possible. So after Mass, you'll have a chance to sponsor. I wanted to mention that in this Father's Day, what we're doing is helping the fathers and mothers of these other countries fulfill their duties. The parents, as you know, are the primary educators of their children. And that's the same all over the world. They're struggling to do that, but we're not replacing them, we're giving them a helping hand. Before Mass, you pray to the intercession of Blessed Stanley Rother, martyr. You're very proud, I'm sure you should be, of your state to have a blessed, soon to be a saint, from Guatemala. Well, from here, the work in Guatemala. Father Stanley and I were ordained the very same day, May 25th, 1963. He in Oklahoma City and I in Wichita. He went to your mission in Guatemala and was martyred. I went to our mission. Wichita had a mission in Venezuela. I went there, but I came back home. So I'm still here, but he's in heaven. So he got the better deal. But he had a much more difficult mission. We never met one another personally, but I've been to his place in Guatemala several times, read his books, and his sister, who's a nun in Wichita, is a good friend of mine. Father Stanley, when he was in his parish down there, had Unbound involved. He had many, many of his parishioners sponsored. And he was a great, very strong supporter of Unbound. So we pray through his intercession for the success of Unbound and many sponsors everywhere we go. So God bless you, and realize that after Mass, you'll have a chance to sponsor. By the way, those on listening on live stream, for you at home who are live streaming the Mass on your computer or TV, we happily invite you also to sponsor. Just click on the St. Benedict's website, St. Benedict's Parish, and find a link on Unbound, and then sponsor, and you'll find the names, the pictures, the countries of those who need sponsoring. And we very much appreciate your support, and you will be blessed mucho, mucho más. If we run out of folders, there's the sheet, a flyer there, that has where you can fill it out, say what you want, anybody or a boy or a girl or elderly in what country, and fill it out, and I'll send it in, and they will send you a folder of that particular child. Well, thank you very much for your attention, for your generosity, and Father Brian for inviting me to your parish today. Let us stand and profess our faith through the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. He rose again according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord's giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. We come to you, Father, with great confidence that you hear and you answer our prayers as you promise.
On this celebration of Father's Day, we pray that Pope Francis, the Holy Father of the Catholic Church, will work courageously to heal and renew this church and to lead all Christians to the truth found only in Jesus Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all men of the parish of St. Benedict who are fathers, may they be leaders of the faith for their families as they provide a loving and stable home for their wives and children. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May this holy church promote a deeper devotion within Catholic people for the sacrifice of the Mass and the blessings that come from adoration of the Blessed Sacrament. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For children from all homeschool families who are making their first Holy Communion this weekend, as they receive the gift of the body, blood, soul, and divinity of Jesus Christ for the first time, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Deacon Robert Healy and Deacon Jonathan Fincher, who will be ordained as priests for the Diocese of Tulsa this week, and for an increase in vocations to the priesthood in our diocese and throughout the nation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the real presence of Jesus Christ in the Eucharist will strengthen all marriages and families, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the ministry of Father Jerry Beat and for the Unbound ministry that our parish will help respond to its need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For healing of all members of our parish who are suffering from illnesses of mind, body, or spirit, as today we pray especially for Ryan Booz, Catherine Snyder, Deacon Dan Brennan, Kevin Stevenson, Charles Jezik, and Patty Kulikowski, and for all those who are listed in our parish bulletin who are suffering from illness, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the souls of all family members and friends who have died, as today we pray especially for Kim Branson, Jeanette Kalins, Betty Burns, Carla Muskrat, Mary Jo Dixon, Richard Roy, Crystal Duffy Urban. Together we pray, eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.
Thank you, Father, for always hearing our prayer. You know what is best for each one of us. Help us to accept your will through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that cleansed by its action, we may make offering of our heart pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father of mercies and faithful God. For you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and our Redeemer. He always showed compassion to poor children and for the poor, for the sick and for sinners, for the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father, and that you care for all your sons and daughters. And so with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name and sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Blessed is he who comes,
art indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "My peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God.
God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, you're not worthy to enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us eternal life.
Thank you.
renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son. We ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption through Christ our Lord.
First off, on behalf of Father Brian and myself, we'd like to thank you, Father Jerry, for your presence here this weekend to preach about something that's very important, to support those who are unable to support themselves and to carry out the gospel values of solidarity with the poor, especially those who are vulnerable, the children, and especially through the ministry of Unbound. And my grandparents themselves actually support a couple of children through this ministry as well. So it's a wonderful ministry. The second thing is, obviously today is Father's Day, so you all get a special Father's Day blessing. So will all the fathers, godfathers, grandparents, and spiritual fathers of the parish please stand? Yes, I could tell by the number of children there'd be a lot of you, which is always good. So bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. God our Father, in your wisdom and love you made all things. Bless these men that they may be strengthened as Christian fathers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. God bless you and happy Father's Day.
Thank you. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace. Thanks be to God.
St. Michael the Archangel,
defend us in the spirit of battle. Be our safe guardians, the wickedness and snares of the devil.
May God be with you.
By the power of God, trust in the heavens.